This is an actual Enigma machine?
Yes, this is one of the few surviving working Enigma machines in the world.
And what's inside?
The rotors that would be set that change the way the pathway goes for the circuit, which lights the lights, which then in the dark would show each letter. So each time you press the letter, a different letter would light up. And what was amazing about the Enigma machine is it was both the coding and the decoding machine in one. The person on the other end typed in the code and it reversed itself so that it could be decoded. In the past, the encoding mechanism was often different from the decoding mechanism. This is a book of logarithmic tables before there were computers to do logarithms.
Right.
You had an entire book filled with logarithms.
I remember this in one of my textbooks when I was a kid. Yeah.
Well, this book is from the 1700s. Are you around in the 1700s?
No, I think we just had a sample of logs there. Right.
So what's amazing is that...
Well, then we had a slide rule to figure that out. Right.
Right. And so the slide rule is right here on the table.
Oh. Okay.
Why? Because the slide rule, but here's a set of Napier bones. And these predate the slide rule. Napier bones were the pre-slide rule calculating method to use a way to use logarithms by using these wooden sticks. People could use Napier bones just like in China they could use an abacus, only Napier bones used a much more sophisticated system. On the table here you see all kinds of different technologies from the history of human imagination. But here's something fun, Paul.
Oh, I remember these guys.
All right. There's an 80-column punch card.
I remember constantly making mistakes when I was trying to punch stuff in on these things.
Here's the beginning of accounting records. This is an Assyrian cone from 2000 BC. So here's an accounting record where a stick is used to make an impression in clay. And here's the 1960s where information is encoded by punching holes in a piece of paper. Yeah. These are 4,000 years apart, Paul, and they're the same idea. Here's the beginning of it all. This is a model of the first transistor, the electronic switch that goes yes and no, that now your watch, your phone, has billions and billions of in a miniaturized form. What does it replace? It replaces this. This is an early computer board from an IBM computer. These vacuum tubes were what happened before there were transistors. And this was all of the circuitry that now gets reproduced on the head of a pin a million times more efficiently.